Good morning, and welcome to Our Lady Star of the Sea. Today we are celebrating the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ on the sixth Sunday of Easter. Please join in singing, Sing with All the Saints in Glory.
Thank you. in honor of the risen Lord, and that we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit. For it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, because it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live and you will live. On that day you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and reveal myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord. Sanctify Christ in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks for a reason for your hope. But do it with gentleness and reverence. These words that St. Peter addresses to the church, it's a church that's suffering persecution, suffering because of their faith. And he reminds them, give to anyone the reason for your hope, why you continue to believe and to proclaim the gospel. And I think in these days of quarantine and then the COVID virus and all of that, it really is an appropriate time for us to reflect on what is the reason for our hope. And it's really important because the world for many seems to be hopeless. And if we think about the many people, you know, who are worried about putting food on the table, concerned about paying rents and mortgages, people have lost their income, fear of the virus itself, and it chips away at hope for the future. You know, living in isolation, little in human interaction, the difficulty again that plays on our ability to hope. Families losing loved ones, fear for the well-being of those people who work in the fields of healthcare, for first responders, and that fear really again gives one pause about the future. The political turmoil that we have in our country that plagues us today. And then there is even this phenomenon of guilt, you know, that I'm doing pretty well and the world around me seems to be collapsing. And here in New Smyrna Beach, we have life in both hands. We can walk the beach, the grocery stores are open, and what can we do? The feeling of helplessness. And now that I have everybody sufficiently depressed about the situation, we turn to the readings. You know, what does it mean? What is our hope? In the gospel today, we hear Jesus promises us his abiding presence. And that abiding presence is promised to us for those who keep his commandments. And the greatest of the commandments is to love one another as I have loved you. Love one another as I have loved the world. And you think about that. Love of enemies. Love of those who persecute you. That's a real tall order for all of us. And yet the hope that lies therein is that Jesus is giving us his Spirit. His Spirit, the Spirit of the Father, the same Spirit to enable us to in fact love. A love that enables us to also cast out fear in order to present ourselves and to love as Jesus loved. And we know that that promise of the gift of the Spirit is fulfilled when the risen Lord breathes on the disciples. And that breath is of mercy and forgiveness. That breath empowers them to go forth and to proclaim the risen Lord, the one who has conquered death and has given us his spirit of love and spirit of life. And it renders the disciples fearless as they go to proclaim the risen Lord and to live and to love as he has loved, even in the face of rejection, even in the face of persecution. And if we look to the first reading today, we see Philip. This is Philip, one of the seven that is chosen to feed the widows in Jerusalem. And in any case, one of the interesting things about those seven men that were chosen and their hands laid upon them to bestow the Spirit upon them is we never see them in the Acts of the Apostles or anywhere else in Scripture actually feeding the widows. And that's because the community is dispersed, destruction of Jerusalem. But it's the same Spirit that leads them to go and to preach in different parts of the world. Philip goes to Samaria, and in any case, and it's here that the Spirit leads him and empowers him to preach the risen Lord. He has no fear of death because our hope is that Christ is risen for all of us and we participate in that. And the Spirit leads him to a very peculiar place because we know Samaritans were centuries-old enemies of Jews. They hated one another. And the Jews looked down upon the Samaritans as quasi-pagans. And it's there that he goes, Philip, and he proclaims the risen Lord. He heals people. He casts out demons. And many people come to believe because his hope is so evident. His hope is linked to his faith in Jesus Christ as risen. And his love also is linked to that faith and to that hope, where he can go even to enemies and bring them into the powerful love of our Lord Jesus Christ. Peter, he's writing, as I said earlier, to encourage Christians who are suffering because of their faith. And he reminds them that Christ suffered for sins once, the just for the sake of the unjust, that they might lead you to God, that might lead you to God. The Christ was dead in the flesh, but has risen in the Spirit. And it is that Spirit who is the source of our hope. The source of our hope today is also the same as the disciples. It means discovering that our obedience to Jesus' commandments to love one another as he has loved. And it is that same Spirit that empowers us to do that. Not only is our hope, but also the one who enables us to open our hearts and to have the courage to approach others as Jesus did in love. It's their experience of this advocate, this one who guides them in truth, and the belief that is the source of that hope. And what it means for us, I guess, is letting ourselves move beyond being paralyzed by our fears, you know, our fears of the events that are going on in the world, and allow the power of the Spirit to spur us on, enabling us to enter into and to serve the needs of the world around us, reaching out and providing hope. Hope by means of our own faith and our steadfastness in it. Hope that emerges from the way we relate in love to one another. And I think that this parish can be proud because we are really a powerful sign of hope in our community. And it's for all of those who support, you know, the human service ministry, those who are actually working in that area, provide hope to people by means of food, by means of helping with rent, mortgages, and utilities. It's such an important thing. But what enables us to do that above all is the Spirit of the risen Lord in us. The Spirit that gives us the courage not to just retreat into our own little world, but rather to do as Jesus did, as Philip was sent by the Spirit to proclaim the news, the good news of Jesus Christ, who casts out all fear by his love and by his being resurrected from the dead. We share in that, and that's our hope, and that's the hope we should always be ready to give reason for to those we meet, both in word and in deed. Now, as a people of hope, we stand and profess that which lies at the center of our lives, saying the words of the Apostles' Creed, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. On the cross, Jesus surrendered his life to the Father. For all men and women, let us pray in confidence of this surrender.
For the Church, that we may continue to extend peace to all those in need, especially victims of war, violence, loss, and other traumas. We pray to the Lord. For leaders of nations that are at war, that they may find a way to peace and avoid further bloodshed. We pray to the Lord. For all who suffer, that they may find joy in the risen Lord, which no one can take away from them. We pray to the Lord. For nurses and doctors, that they continue to serve and heal in freedom of conscience. For the sick, that they be restored to health, and for the dying, that they be welcomed into God's heavenly city. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who cannot accept the Spirit of truth, that their hearts be converted. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our local church and parish community, that we love Christ and sanctify him as Lord in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Glenn Matthew, Jack L. Warner, Brian Meister, Jared Piakowski, Carmela Valvano, and Joseph DeFeo, in whose memory this Mass is celebrated, may they receive the reward of eternal life, and may those who mourn their loss be comforted. We pray to the Lord. Let us pause for a moment of silence to pray for the needs we hold close to our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God, source of all goodness and holiness, you sent the Holy Spirit to guide us. Lead us in right paths and listen to our prayer through Jesus Christ, who is our risen Lord forever and ever.
As we prepare the table of the Lord and offer up our gifts, please join in singing Prayer of St. Francis.
And where there's a
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose day of death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Francis and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed sisters and brothers, and to all who were pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Now let us pray with confidence to our Heavenly Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
So offer to those near us a sign of our peace in Christ.
this bread.
One entrance, one exit, and also to wear masks. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us and keep us this day and bring us to this evening in peace, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us walk this week in the light and in the love of Christ Jesus. Thanks be to God.
As we go to serve the Lord, please join in singing, Alleluia, love is alive.